Well, stocks might be at all-time highs, but my next guest says the Fed will start tapering soon, and that will put a total halt to this rally. Joining me now is Barry Knapp. He's managing partner and director of research at Ironside's Macroeconomics. Barry, it's good to have you. I think this is the perfect time to have you because you're very focused on the mechanisms, the mechanics of markets, and not just these top-level calls. Why is it that you think the taper triggers a market reset?
There's three channels that the taper or slowing of asset purchases works its way through the markets. The one that most economists, strategists, Fed policy participants focus on is the signaling or discounting effect. I think what if we hear anything from Chair Powell this week, it'll be about separating rate hikes from the actual taper process. They'll do everything they can to try and deliver a dovish taper. That's only one of the three channels. The other two that rarely get discussed, the second one is a move higher in real rates. When you discount stocks, you create an equity risk premium model, you use the real interest rate. Even last week, as Fed officials talked more about a potential taper, Steve Leisman reported that's a higher probability. You saw a spike higher in real rates in the front end. That's what happened in the taper tantrum, which was actually the smallest of the equity market corrections, but that we had two spikes in real rates in 18 and 19. And then the third channel, the one that never gets discussed, Kelly, is the volatility channel. And that is because when the Fed buys mortgages, 100% of the net supply in this case, they suppress mortgage prepayment risk. They don't hedge it. The private sector does need to. And so it causes interest rate volatility to go up. That causes equity volatility to go up,
sure.
And that's where these risk-off shocks come from.
So, again, kind of the signaling issue, real rates issue, just volatility issue. We have all three of these things. And what do you say to those who go, no, it's priced in. The taper is priced in. The markets are shrugging it off. They are looking past it. They are, you know, why don't you, what if it doesn't create a 10 to 15% correction?
Well, I think with real rates, and you've heard people like my former colleague, Rick Rieder, talk about real rates just being in the wrong place. They're incredibly low. So I doubt very few would argue with my point that when the Fed stops buying $120 billion a month, that real rates won't go up, right? That's primarily what they've been doing. And anyone who looks at interest rate volatility would have to acknowledge it's way below its long-term medium. I have it more than a standard deviation between its long-term medium, that will go up as well. So with those two factors so cheap, it's really difficult to argue that this whole thing is priced into the markets. You can argue all you want that we've talked about it and that means it's priced,
right.
But those two asset classes in particular, real interest rates and interest rate volatility, are so far below their long-term means that it can't possibly be.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.